Hey guys, this is MVtv. My name is Raul.
And I'm Lizzie.
And we'll be right back to you after this short opener.
If you want it, you can have it. But you gotta learn to reach out there and grab it. Cause everybody wants some love. Shoot it from the stars above. And though my heart will break, there's more than I could take. I could never get enough. If you need it, you should show it. Cause in my place, so monastic that you blow it.
Hey guys, so this is our first announcement from the CTE department. There's a 9-week coding boot camp offered to any high school or graduating senior. Any student is eligible. You don't need any experience. For any information on that, it's at www.ctsutah.com to apply, or you could ask any CTE teacher about it. Go ahead and apply for that. It's going to be really fun.
Yeah, and our next announcement is from Student Council about interview signups. Any juniors still interested in running for a rep or class position on Student Council and haven't already been interviewed, there is a sign-up sheet posted outside of the Student Council room. Interviews will be held on Monday, April 10th and Tuesday, April 11th when we get back from spring break.
So FCCLA did have their state competition this last week. They did really good. The following students received silver medals. Amron Biggs, Katie Stamen, Courtney Shadburn in sports nutrition. Casey Jones and Sophie Mergarian received that in child development. Hallie McKell received a gold medal and third place in state in foods innovation. Emma Stoddard and Alyssa Miner received a gold medal and first place in state sports nutrition. Chloe Harmon received a gold medal and first place in state sports nutrition and occupation. So great job to them.
Yep. In addition, Hallie McKell received a $1,000 scholarship to become a FACTS teacher. Chloe Harmon, Emma Stoddard, and Alyssa Miner all received first place in their events and will be going to the National FCCLA competition in Nashville.
So they did a great job. If you do end up seeing them in the hallway or anything, make sure to give them a congratulation. So the Battle of the Bruin Bowl is coming up. Sign up today before spring break to reserve your spot. There will be a table in the Commons during lunch if you want to sign up, or to go to MVHS website to go sign up. It's going to be really great. I believe there's a $500 reward. So, I mean, who doesn't want to win $500? So next we have a video announcement from Tay Lawrence, and we're going to go kick off with that.
All right, so it is time for the annual Peeps Diorama Contest. So how the contest works, you have to create a simple, just like this one, diorama using Peeps marshmallows. The design must be based off a book, and the top three winners are going to be winning some Amazon gift cards. So if you want to take a shot at winning those, you're welcome to come to the library and sign up. All right, so congratulations to the Wind Symphony. They received superior ratings at their region concert and at the band festival. Yesterday, they qualified for the state band festival, so great job. This is the 20th year in a row they have qualified, so way to go, band. All right, so any sophomores or juniors that are interested in doing student council next year, there's gonna be a meeting April 10th at 1:15. Make sure you come to that, and also if you're interested in signing or putting up some posters and having them approved, come at 7 a.m. or 7 o'clock, and then that will get you, then they can approve that. It's gonna be in this room right over here. Okay, now we're gonna play a video right now. This is about some Star Wars trivia that was asked last week.
Hey, what's up, Bruins? This is Stefano, or Stefano. We're here at Mountain View High School, obviously. We're gonna be asking different classes some Star Wars trivia, and they have 5 seconds to answer. Let's do it. In Empire Strikes Back, which hand of Luke Skywalker does Darth Vader cut off?
Right hand.
What ship does Han Solo pilot?
Oh, the Millennium Falcon.
Yes, 10.
Hey, Hallie.
Alright, who directed The Force Awakens?
That's the one guy who did Star Trek as well.
What's his name, Hallie?
Not George Lucas. Wait, first letter.
Okay. What race is Chewbacca?
He is a hybrid between a chocolate lab and giant hamsters.
It's a J.
I know, okay.
Second letter is JJ. In A New Hope, who is the person that Han Solo kills in the canteen?
Greedo.
In A New Hope, what was Obi-Wan's hiding name?
Ben Kenobi.
Here we go, you ready? Who owns Cloud City?
It's that guy who wears like all white and he has brown skin.
Okay, what's his name?
I don't know.
You know his name. Come on, Noah, please.
I don't know his name.
Are you ready?
Han Solo.
No.
Oh, okay.
All right, you ready?
You're ready. Go for it.
What type of farm does Luke Skywalker work at?
A farm that grows vegetables.
All right. How many languages does C-3PO know? Wild guess, right now. Two. In A New Hope, what type of milk does Luke Skywalker drink with his family?
I have no idea. That is impossible.
No idea?
Chewbacca milk.
All right, here we go. Who is the bounty hunter that follows the Millennium Falcon?
Boba Fett.
Awesome. Didn't know I was unlocked.
I just want to ask you a question. You have 5 seconds to answer it. This is Star Wars trivia. You think you can do it?
I can answer any Star Wars.
You can answer any Star Wars question. You have 5 seconds to get points for your class. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, go ahead.
In A New Hope, what cell number is Princess Leia?
Holy crap
is not the right answer. That's 5 seconds.
Oh man, that's a hard question.
We're over 5 seconds.
Cell number 37.
All right, Bruins, that's a wrap. That's all we have for Star Wars trivia. It turns out faculty got 5 points, seniors got 15 points, and juniors and sophomores both got 20 points. Later.
Okay, now we have a promotional video from the red team.
Mr. Fong is older than Gandhi. Mountain View is ghetto. I love Orem. What is this?
This calls to assemble the red team.
Entire red team here. Send a text.
Done. Here you go.
Yeah. It's actually really high.
Jack, did you text Faith?
I thought I did.
She
should be here by now.
I thought
she said she was coming.
Right, that's why I'm really confused. I thought I texted her.
Guys, I'm right here.
Didn't you guys say Madison here earlier?
Yeah, she's out on the tram.
She's out on the tram.
Yeah, she's been out there.
Really? How long?
What
is she doing?
Tram.
Why would she be out there on the tram?
Doing?
What the?
Something terrible has come to my attention. We're losing school spirit. Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
Start the red invasion.
So was a fun video from the red team. Now we're moving on to our student of the days. Our first student of the day is Trevor Mangum from Mr. Weinecke, the math teacher. He says, many of us know that Trevor is a fantastic mathematics student. However, not everyone knows how willing and talented he is at helping others at solve mathematical problems. I do not think there is a day that goes by in a classroom where Trevor does not help someone develop better understanding. Thank you, Trevor, for not being a bad student. So good job, Trevor.
Yeah, our second student of the day is Ethan Walker from Mrs. Hewlett, the math teacher. Ethan is a pleasure to have in class. He is always happy and has a positive attitude even when the concepts are difficult. Ethan is definitely a top student in his very talented class. He has quite a knack for mathematics. Thank you for taking my class, Ethan. Keep up the good work.
So good job, Trevor and Ethan. That's all for today. Thank you very much. This is MVtv. My name is Raul.
And this is Lizzie.
We'll be right back to you after.